These are the best updated settings about how to speed up Windows 10 PC performance in 2024 and beyond for a faster computer or laptop, especially if you have an old system or poor RAM or hardware condition. You don't need to throw your PC away, because I'll reveal everything you need to know that will make your Windows 10 computer 10 times faster than ever before. Please note that you'll have to restart your system after applying these settings to make the changes take effect. So instead of restarting our PC each time after we apply these settings one by one, we will restart it and after applying all the settings at once. Also, don't miss the super important last method, especially if you want to use your computer for gaming or graphics related work. We'll start from the simplest to the most advanced solution in this guide. Alright, let's get started. Method 1. Turn off background apps. To do that, press Windows I hotkey and go to privacy. Scroll down to background apps. If this is turned on, set this to off. I've already shared another detailed guide on this topic that contains more fixes like this one, so be sure to check out that one as well after this video. Also, before moving ahead, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe so that you don't miss more Windows 10 tips and tricks like this one. Moving on, the next step on our tutorial is method 2, turn off Windows tips and tricks. Windows often uses resources on your system to deliver unwanted notification in the form of tips and tricks, so we can turn that off. To do that, press Windows plus I again, go to system, then select notifications and actions and uncheck the last two options. If you find these to check, uncheck them. To further speed up Windows 10 performance, we can increase the mouse and menu response time. To do that, we need to open the registry editor by pressing Windows R and type REZ edit and click on S. Now we need to go to S key current user control panel and double click on mouse, and then we're gonna find here mouse hover time, and we're gonna change the value data from 400 to 10. Okay, or press enter, and then we're gonna double click on the desktop folder and find menu show delay. Double click on it and change the value from 400 to 10 and click on OK or press enter. And finally, you'll have to restart your system, but wait, we'll do it at the end. No need to restart it now. Next up in this guide about how to speed up Windows 10 performance, we can disable startup programs. In order to do that, press Ctrl plus Shift plus Escape on your keyboard. This will launch the task manager, and then we need to go to the startup tab, and here you will find different programs that automatically run while your computer loads or boots up. For example, we have this Brave VPN WireGuard service as the audio background process, and you can see their status here. Disabled, this one is disabled, and this one is enabled. So you can find the unnecessary programs that you don't need to launch at the start of the system, and then just right click on them and select disable. Next on how to speed up Windows 10 computer is to delete temporary files and cache files or cache files. So simply press Windows plus R and then type %temp and press enter, and what we're gonna do is select all of these files, shift delete, and do this for all current items. Alright, the file catalyst is the system file. If you remove it, Windows or another program may no longer work correctly. So what you need to do is do this for all current items and skip it. So if you get any kind of these errors, just skip them. It's safe to skip them than to delete them. And now type Windows R again, type temp and press enter. And now we're gonna delete all of these files here. And once again, we're gonna press Windows R and we're gonna type prefetch. And then we're gonna delete all these files. If you get any kind of this error, just skip them. So what we basically did is clear cache or temp file from our Windows 10 PC. I've already shared a detailed guide on how to clear the cache files completely. If you want that guide, I'll leave a link to it in the description or in the comments or in the I button in the top right corner of the screen. Be sure to check it out as well. Next up on how to speed up Windows 10 laptop is to use the disk cleanup. Press Windows R and type clean MGR and press enter, and then we're gonna select the drive you want to clean up. So it's basically the C drive where the Windows installations file are stored. So we're gonna click on OK. All these files, we're gonna select them, and there is nothing much here. Just click on OK, delete files, and it's gonna delete all the leftovers or temporary files. You'll need to provide administrative permission to delete this folder. Just do this. It won't make any difference to your system, because this process is completely safe. And once again, press Windows R again and type clean MGR, but this time press Ctrl Shift Enter and this will launch this cleanup with administrative privileges. Click on OK. These are the system files. You need to select everything here and click on OK, and they will get deleted permanently. Alright, next up on how to speed up your computer Windows 10 is to enable storage sense. To do that, press Windows plus I, then go to System, Storage, then turn on the radio button next to the storage sense, and then click on Configure Storage Sense or run it now. Run storage sense, maybe a day, week or month based on your preferences. This will automatically clear up the unwanted junk on your drives. So I'm gonna select every week, maybe a month. You are free to choose any of these options. And the temporary files, delete the file in my recycle bin if they have been there for over. This is all your choice. Like, it will automatically clean up these files after it reaches this certain time frame. You can also free up space by using clean now. Alright, it says cleaning up file. This may take a few minutes. It says done. We are able to free up 5.72 megabytes of disk space. Next up on how to increase the speed of Windows 10 is to optimize drives. To do this, press Windows plus R and type DFRGUI and press Enter. This will open up the optimized drive window. So what we need to do is select the drive where your installation files are stored, such as the C drive, which is already selected. We need to click on the optimize option here, and you can see the status here. It is currently analyzing. We're gonna have to wait for this process to complete. There is nothing much more to do here, so we can close this. Once the process is complete, you can see the process here, like it says pass 2% consolidated. So that's all. Now if you are looking for how to make Windows 10 faster, we can enable the high performance settings, which is our next step in the tutorial. First of all, we need to unlock a setting called high performance. To do that, press Windows plus R and type CMD and press Ctrl Shift Enter and click on S. This will launch the command prompt with administrative privileges. We need to launch a small code here. So we need to write power cfg slash s scheme in capital underscore min. And then we need to click enter, type exit to exit out of the command prompt, then type Windows R, type in power cfg.cpl. As you can see, the settings are already set to high performance, and exit out of this. Next on how to speed up Windows 10 PCs to disable unnecessary services, we need to launch the run dialog box, Windows R, and type msconfig, press enter. It has launched this system configuration. Now we need to switch to the services tab and check hide all Microsoft services. It's gonna prevent you from disabling services that are essential for your system to operate. So we're not gonna disable those services. And if you want, then you can uncheck the services related to your graphics drivers, such as AMD External Events Utility, Intel R Graphics Command Center services. You can uncheck them, but you can, by the way, disable other services like the PDF shoot. I don't need that. I'm gonna uncheck these. Brave update service, this PDF shoot, and all these services, I can disable them. And then I'm gonna click on disable all, then apply, then click on OK. It says system configuration. You may need to restart your computer to apply these changes before restarting. Save any open files and close all programs. I'm gonna exit without restart. We're gonna restart the system at the end of the video when we are done applying all other solutions. So I'm gonna exit without restart. To get the best of how to speed up your PC Windows 10, we can disable certain visual effects. So we need to launch the run dialog box, Windows R, and type sysdm.cpl systemcpl. It has brought up the system properties. We need to go to advanced, and under performance we need to click on settings. We're in the visual effect tab. You'll find checkboxes that consume resources while applying visual effects. Please note that some visual effects might be turned off after applying the changes. This should only be applied if you don't need them. You need to click on adjust for best performance radio button over here, and then click on apply, and then click on OK. And we're gonna exit out of this by clicking on OK again. To further increase the speed of Windows 10, we can increase the committed KB or virtual memory, which is equivalent to physical RAM, not in technical terms but similar to it. So first of all, we need to check our virtual memory. We need to press Windows R to launch it on dialog box and type in MS. We're gonna type in MSinfo32 and press enter, and this is gonna bring up the system information window, and we're gonna scroll down. I'm gonna double click on this, and it says install physical memory. RAM is around 8 GB. We can also go to settings by pressing Windows I, system, storage, show more categories, and click on system and reserved. And here we can see system files, size, reserve storage, virtual memory like 12.2 GB, hibernation file 3.16 GB, system restore 1.02 GB. What we're gonna do is take a note of our installed physical memory, which is 8 GB. We're gonna take a note of that. Then we're gonna change the total virtual memory capacity. This is basically making the space on your hard drive act as RAM. Minimize this and press Windows R and sysdm.cpl again and enter. And then we're gonna go to the advanced tab, then click on settings under performance, and then we're gonna go to advanced tab, and under virtual memory we're gonna change it. So we need to do a couple of calculations here. You might have this option called automatically manage paging file size for all drives. We're gonna uncheck them, and then you will find custom size like initial size in megabytes and maximum size in megabytes. I have entered these numbers here. You don't need to enter them. You need to calculate them and then enter them. This is for my system only, and this will not work for your system. And there is formulae or equation to calculate this. Calculating the amount of memory we need for the initial size megabyte is the actual RAM size of your PC or actual size of your installed RAM, and then multiplied by 1 MB into 1.5, which is the minimum recommended by Microsoft. So we're gonna bring up the calculator here. Go to coordinates and type calculator. So first and foremost, what we're gonna do is enter our installed RAM number here. So we're gonna type in 8 here, and then we're gonna multiply that by 1 MB. 1 MB is approximately around 1024 KB, so we're gonna type 1024, and then we're gonna multiply it by 1.5, and we're gonna total that out, and it gives 12288, and that's the exact number we have input here. And the other box is the maximum file size. The maximum file size is basically the three times of RAM capacity. So we're gonna calculate that. So we're gonna clear out everything. So first of all, we're gonna enter the amount of our RAM in gigabytes. We're gonna type in 8. It could be 4, it could be 16, it could be 32 for you. So you're gonna change that number according to your installed RAM capacity. So I'm gonna multiply that by 1 MB, approximately around 1024 KB, and this is gonna get multiplied by 3, and it gives 24576, which is the exact number I have entered here. And after that, I need to click on set and then click on OK. You will find the option for apply here. Then we're gonna click on OK, and once we are done with that, we're gonna restart our system. But there is more, and we're gonna restart our system at the end of the tutorial. Next on how to speed up computer Windows 10 is to uninstall necessary programs. Here is how to uninstall unused programs on your Windows 10 computer. Press Windows R, type Control Panel and press Enter. Go to View By, and if you have large icons or small icons, you need to select by category, then click on uninstall a program, and from the list of different programs here, you need to right click on it and select uninstall, and then follow the on-screen instruction, and it's gonna uninstall the program associated with it. Make sure that you do clearing cache process after uninstalling the program, because every program will leave some kind of leftovers. I've already shared a detailed guide on uninstalling apps downloaded from the Microsoft Store. Be sure to check it out as well after this video ends. Method adding a SSD solid state drive. You need to listen to this carefully. This is just honest advice for general information, and I'm not promoting anything here, nor I'm affiliated with any product. If you want to make Windows 10 faster by any means necessary, then you need to install SSD. However, this will require you some budget. In some cases, even after applying the fixes so early in the video, your computer might still be slow. That's basically because old models of Windows come with a default hard drive that is relatively slow compared to a solid state drive. SSDs are relatively faster than hard drive and very cheap to afford. For example, if your boot time is 100 seconds on a hard drive, it could be down to 10 seconds on an SSD, and speed increased by 10 times using an SSD. The read and write speed of SSD on average computer is around 125 MB/s, and it will be further divided into parts if multiple services are running in the background. On the other hand, the average speed of a general SSD, which you can easily find on the market, is around 450 MB/s. So you can see the speed difference already here. And the best part is you can install an SSD and also keep a hard drive on your computer together at the same time. There are SSDs priced under $20 as well on Amazon for Western countries such as the United States, Britain and other countries. In countries like India and Nepal, you can get it for as low as 2000 rupees. It just depends upon the store you are visiting. Next up on how to speed up your computer is to upgrade your RAM only if you have enough money to invest. Adding a new SSD and RAM will turn your old computer and make it perform like a brand new. And they are super cheap as well. You can add a new graphics card as well, but we will exclude it from our conversation as graphics cards are relatively expensive as compared to RAM and SSD. However, we have to check the limit that our computer supports for the maximum amount of RAM it can handle. It's not like you have enough money and you can go buy 64 GB of RAM and install it on your computer. The system must support it. Also, there are models for RAM such as DDR3, DDR4, DDR2 and so on. Before you upgrade, you need to ensure that your system supports it or not, and also check if there is an extra slot for the hardware you're installing. There are even RAM found in sites like Amazon and eBay that are found under $25 in United States or similar countries. In India or Nepal, you can get it for as cheap as 3000 rupees to 6000 rupees on a budget, and if you have enough money, then that's good. So that's basically how to speed up Windows 10 PC performance to make it faster in 2024 and beyond. If you enjoyed this video and find it helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.